let's begin this morning with the news that dropped last night. I think it was right around 6 or 7 o'clock Eastern time. Elon Musk coming out and tweeting the following. Tesla has suspended vehicle purchases using Bitcoin. We are concerned about rapidly increasing use of fossil fuels for Bitcoin mining and transactions, especially coal, which has the worst emissions of any fuel. Cryptocurrency is a good idea on many levels, and we believe it has a promising future, but this cannot come at great cost to the environment. Tesla will not be selling any Bitcoin, and we intend to use it for transactions as soon as mining transactions or transitions rather to more sustainable energy. We are also looking at other cryptocurrencies that use less than 1% of Bitcoin's energy per transaction. So, Julie, we all know, we've heard from many people that cryptocurrency can be volatile. We see that on display this morning. I guess we'll get into the details of, you know, like what crypto people think about Elon's actual, you know, comments with respect to energy consumption. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. But your just first impressions that Elon can come out and tweet this and it moves the market that much.
Well, there are two sides of this story. There is the Tesla and this guy being the CEO of a public company over which he, you know, he has fiduciary duties on the one hand, and then there's the crypto effect on the other. And if I can just speak for a second about the first, they have a lot of this on the balance sheet, and he just made it go down a lot. You know, and we talk frequently. Lately, the narrative has been more that there's been a sort of stability in his tweets, perhaps to some extent, at least with direct regards to the company. And yet then you get something like this. And so you just, like, you have to question the guy's judgment, right, from time to time. Yes, you can argue he's a visionary in terms of what he has done for electric vehicles, in terms of what he's done for cryptocurrencies to some extent also. But then, you know, you do something like this. Remember when we had that whole discussion about whether other companies were going to put Bitcoin on their balance sheets in large measure? And I think Brian Sazi were arguing that maybe we'd see more companies doing this. This is an example of why that is not going to happen, at least not right now. And for me, that, yes, the cryptocurrency side of it, the story is also very interesting. But oof, his investors, if I were them, I would not be too pleased right now.
Yeah, Julie, I remember we asked AutoNation CEO Mike Jackson on the same day that they reported earnings that Elon Musk came out, said he put Bitcoin on their balance sheet. And he's like, no, I'm not putting this on my balance sheet, because essentially that investment in Bitcoin, if you were an AutoNation or any other company, would be controlled by tweets from in the likes of this from an Elon Musk. But, you know, Miles, I'm really curious to ask you and a lot of our guests, does his tweet bring up a very important point on the mining aspect of Bitcoin? And if so, and it does it change the fundamental reason to invest in crypto?
Well, we'll get to that in just a second with someone who knows more about that, than any of us. I just think the psychology here behind this is what interests me, like the meta level of, you know, why does Elon tweeting this matter? The thing with Elon is he's a lightning rod, right? But there's this, and to the discussion we're having about companies putting Bitcoin on the balance sheet, that was seen by many in the crypto community as a coronation moment for crypto. And indeed, we may see more companies go ahead and add Bitcoin to their balance sheet, continue to take it as payment. But there's this you know, kind of double thing at work with Elon specifically, that when he says it and it agrees with me, it is good in the future and definitively, you know, he's such a smart guy, this is perfect. When it disagrees, then it becomes this, well, you know, Elon's in a lot of different areas. He doesn't really know what he's talking about here. Like, let's not worry about Elon's expertise in all these things, because remember, this guy is stretched pretty thin. So it's definitely, you know, heads I win, tails you lose. And obviously that's at the core of finance, Julie, right? Like finding a way for everything to break your way. But the you know, conversation, the meme around Elon's confirmation, but then also, oh, he's just joking. I find that just to be fascinating, because that's going to come up again in other areas, whether it's, you know, Bitcoin or anything else he talks about.
Of course. I mean, but in this thing in particular, like to your point, Brian, you know, does this bring up an interesting point about Bitcoin? Sure, but it's not a new one, right? Like the energy usage complaint about Bitcoin is not new. And even though he tweeted a chart this morning that seems to show that energy usage is ticking up. It doesn't necessarily show the fossil fuel generated energy usage. So, you know, I don't know why now. That's something, Julia, that is a bit confusing to me.
I would just add, too, for a lot of people, I think, that have been lured into the Bitcoin trade, let's say over the past month or two, following the likes of tweets from Elon Musk, you name, and other big names in the space, to them, this mining issue might just be new. And I wouldn't be surprised if that's why you're partly seeing some of that sell-off, because others are fearing that maybe some of these big whale people like a Musk dump Bitcoin.